super awesome as a mentor, but they just don't feel comfortable doing it. Do not require them to do it. Allow them to opt out if it's something that they're not comfortable doing. If this is something that you bring into your company and it's a new thing, maybe they'll see one junior developer come through this kind of scenario that you've set up, and maybe they see them become successful and eventually they'll decide to join. But don't require people to do it if it's something that they don't are not interested in doing. Managers are not mentors. I'd like to really stress on this. Managers can be super great mentors, and I don't disagree with that. But the thing is that mentors or mentees need to feel comfortable bringing up questions about things that maybe they should know. Maybe they don't know what CSS stands for. Maybe they don't know what React is. Maybe they don't know something, and they inside they're like, I know I should know this, but I don't know it. Don't put them with a manager. They're not going to feel comfortable saying, hey, what is the answer to this question that I feel like I should already know? Partner them with someone that they can, again, really to create those bonds with and feel comfortable asking what they might think is stupid questions. Open lines of communication. This is going to be different for each company, but set up a way that there is an open line of communication. Maybe you've got a set office hours once a week, or maybe it's, hey, there's a Slack channel that's always here for anyone who has questions about X or code or whatever it might be. Find a way to create that open line of communication so that they know that there is always an avenue or a place that they can ask a question and feel completely comfortable. Track progress and make goals. As someone who's ambitious and new to the industry, they are going to want this. They are going to want to know what they should strive to succeed to, and maybe they don't know that learning React is something that they should spend time on. Maybe they don't know that learning animations in CSS3 is something that they want to do because they don't know what they don't know. So create goals for them. Work with their mentor. Work with them to track their progress and create goals. And then make sure that you reward those goals. Really put a lot of emphasis on working hard to getting to this end result that you're looking for. And build a program. So as I've been kind of chatting through this, you can kind of get a feel that like if you're going to start to do this, like if you can create a program and get set developers involved and get new developers involved. Once they've gone through this program, you can actually convert them into mentors. So they will be able to relate to the new mentees a lot easier than someone who has been in the industry for a while. And they've gone through it recently. They'll be able to say, great, you've gone through this. Let me help you. Let me be your friend. Here's a great person to talk to if you want to learn about, you know, whatever. Here's another person to talk to if you want to learn about something else. Create a program with these people that you've already taught. Alright, so we're going to move on to developers. So if you are just personally a developer or personally just anyone in the organization that you want to do, if you just want to mentor, this part's going to be for you. Alright, so reasons as to why, there's usually a title here, but reasons as to why you want to do it, why you should be a developer is what we're going to chat about first. What I actually really liked about it was growing my network. So once I joined Girl Development and once I started teaching classes, then I would actually meet people in the audience or in that classroom. They might have been like project managers, or maybe they were business analysts, or maybe they were designers, but they were all with like different companies. And so I met a lot of really great people from a lot of really big companies and grew my network pretty quickly. Before I actually worked at Pantheon, I worked at General Mills. And the General Mills job I got because I had met someone in a Girl Development class. And she's like, you're amazing, you need to work for us. And it blossomed into a job. So it will help you grow your network if you're personally job looking, or if you just want that network to be able to reach out to. Maybe inside your company you've got projects, but sometimes you need additional help. Growing your network can help you in so many different ways. Jobs, resources, just friends. It's just a great way to kind of grow that network. It feels good. So this is my official title for any type of mentorship or volunteering. I call it a selfish act of selflessness. So selfishly, it makes me feel amazing. So I do it because I feel good. But at the end of the day, it's a kind act, and I'm helping somebody else. And we both just feel good. So it is something that just makes everyone all around feel really good. Step outside So you can do different things that will help you kind of broaden out that comfort zone and not just stay in your day-to-day. I go to work, I go home, I go to work, I go home. It'll help you kind of grow out of that. And if you like beer, there's usually beer at like tons of tech events. Wow, that was funny. Master your own skill. So teaching means that you need to know your stuff. It was actually kind of interesting. So the first time I taught the Girl Development CSS class, we talked about colors. And I think originally it was like CSS had the 16 standard colors, like blue, green, you can actually write them out. So I taught that, and one of my students was like, oh, did you know that this website says there's like 147? I was like, there's 147 colors? Hey, turns out that CSS3 offered out 147 colors, and I thought it was 16. Like, I don't Google to see what colors they are. Normally I'm using hexadecimal colors or RGB colors. And it was just one of those things, like when you teach things, you start to refresh yourself on some of these skills. So if you start to teach an intro to JavaScript, maybe you're so in your way of doing things that you forget, like, these are the foundations. Or, oh yeah, you can do it like that. It just also just gets you better at doing what you're doing because you're teaching someone else how to do that. Their successes feel like your successes. So this kind of also plays into the selfish acts of selflessness. But when they succeed and they get their first job, it's like a huge party internally for you. You have helped them. You have guided them. You've given them tips to help them become better developers. And when they get a job, it's just very exciting for you. I actually have a few different students that have gone through my classes. And I just had a CSS class like a week and a half ago. And this is like super, super amazing for me. But she went through all my classes. So after kind of going through the first set of classes, I actually ended up writing a standard HTML class. From HTML, you move to CSS. And from CSS, you move to like web concepts. Then from there, you decide if you want to do JavaScript or whatever else. And she came to all of my classes. She went to all the JavaScript classes. She did the WordPress class. And I haven't seen her for about a year or so. She came into my class as a TA. So she volunteered a TA. And I found out that she was in an internship for a React role. So she took the skills that I gave her and that other people through Girl Development gave her and actually went and got an internship job, and she's going through interviews right now for a full-time developer role. And it's just like, it feels so good. And that success, like, it just gives me like goosebumps. It's just amazing that I helped contribute to that. Plus, you make new lifelong friendships. I have a woman who is from northern Minnesota, and she would drive down to the Twin Cities to come to my classes and come to some of the other classes we're offering. And we're now like great friends. She's all over my Twitter all the time. She's on my Facebook page. We're constantly talking about how she's doing, how I'm doing. It's just a friendship that is always going to continue to be there because we went through so much together. All right, so you learn about why and why you should be a mentor, mainly because it feels good and you're helping other people. But where should you find them? Where can you go to find mentors? Colleges or schools. We're obviously in one right now. Colleges and universities can be pretty large. What I actually recommend is that you find out who the director is in that specific program. So if there's a development program or a design program or any type of computer science program, figure out who that director are or who some of those leads are, and they can help guide you into maybe certain students, or maybe they've already got some type of program that they do, or maybe they've got some meetups or something that they do. So just start to reach out to where you feel like those candidates are going to be. I also want to put a little emphasis on high school. You know, obviously that's a little bit touchy. They're under 18 children, so you need to be a little bit more careful and figure out how that works logistically for you. But they're also very passionate. Like, there are a lot of kids that already know that this is exactly what they want to do. And if you can help them when they're younger, that's even better. I also actually optionally teach a like kids coding class. And it's so fun because the school that I taught at was mainly like Hispanic students. It was about 85% Hispanic students. And then the rest kind of broke down from there, which is pretty uncommon for Minneapolis. Like, who wants to go to Minneapolis? It's colder. But it was awesome because some of the students came in because they were required to take extra credit, take that kind of credit for school. And so they're like, oh, well, we think this coding class is going to be super easy, so we're just going to take that. And they came in there, and they're pretty grumpy. They did not want to talk to me. They did not want to write to code. And I started just doing some basic stuff on the internet right away. Super quick change I just did with FTP. And then all of a sudden it like hit them and it was like, whoa, you can change the internet in like a matter of minutes. And once they saw that, they were very excited. And so I turned this like group of students into like, oh, we're just stuck here because we have to be here, to like 10 students that were like, oh yeah, I'm gonna be a coder someday. Like this is amazing. Like I'm gonna start taking computer science classes. Like I wanna learn about computers more. And it's super awesome. So don't rule out anyone who might be younger or who might be in even elementary school. I'm trying to get my kids to code. They're not really having it, but I'm still trying. Cold schools or boot camps. That's actually where I really got started. Girl Development definitely played into that, but a lot of times I met a lot of people in those classes who were coming from our code school in Minneapolis. And that's where I met a lot of the people that I know now and a lot of people that still continue to reach out to me on LinkedIn. Just had like 4 people reach out from some recent classes and like, oh, I hear that you really care about mentorship. And that's exciting to me because someone is telling someone and that's like what I care about. But if you have a code school or a boot camp, those are really great places because they're trying to learn very quickly and they really need someone to just give them that quick advice that they need to just get through that program. Local organizations or groups, anything that's on Meetup that is tech-related, maybe it's even just a WordPress Meetup group, maybe it's a different kind of Meetup group, maybe there's a web industries one, maybe there's actually a Girl Development or a Women Who Code or Yes We Code in your area. All of those places are going to have people that want to learn to code. Hackathons. These are not only super fun, but also a great place to meet people. In Minneapolis, we have one that one of our agencies puts on, and it is all for nonprofits. So we build websites for nonprofits. It's 24 hours, you don't get to leave, you can sleep if you want. But for the most part, it's go, go, go for 24 hours. And although it's exhausting, it's so exciting because the people on our team, I actually love the team that we did. And I found some experienced developers, we had a few experienced that we could really get to through some of their hard code stuff. But the other 3 or 4 people that were on our team came from code schools. And they were all newer, but they were so ambitious and so excited to learn. So we gave them a lot of the things that they had knowledge in. One of them was really good with CSS. So we're like, here you go, here's the design, like, just make this for us. Someone was like really good at JavaScript. So then they ended up creating something that we needed for this crazy advanced form. It's just really cool that not only on your team can you meet people, but you also get to meet other people on other teams. So we had other people that were like taking a break or maybe just walking around. And it's a great place to just meet people in general as well as find people who want to learn to code. Conferences, where we are at today. In just a little bit, I'm going to put you all on the spot and kind of express your interest in this. Is it too quiet? Okay. It's hard to hold it right here. But conferences are a great place to also meet people. You can, you know, just walk up to someone or, you know, whatever it might be. Finding people at a conference that are looking for this is also a great place to find them. All right, so we learned about why. We learned about where to find them. Now I want to teach you about how you can be a good mentor once you find those people. Boost their confidence. I would say by far this is like your number one job, is boost their confidence. They're going to come in and they're going to be excited to learn, but they're also going to be hesitant about the things that they are capable of doing. Right? They may have gone through a coding program, they may have gone through a college. Really depending on what their education is, they're going to have a different level of confidence. And it's really important that we give them the confidence that they need to be able to move forward. Even the most experienced developer gets imposter syndrome. I can't even tell you in a week how many times I think that I made the wrong industry choice. I'll be working on a coding example and all of a sudden I'm like, I don't know how to do this. And then I'm like, should I even be a developer? Why am I even here? How did I get this job? Should I quit before they realize that I'm an imposter? And that happens weekly. It's like this emotional roller coaster. And we really need to encourage junior developers to get through that. Like, it's hard. It's hard to get through some of that stuff. And allow them to feel good about the fact that they can do it and that we all will do that. Guide their career path. So one note here, like, don't tell them what to do, but ask them the questions that will help you give them advice. So I had someone who just reached out like 6 months ago and they're like, hey, I just got out of Prime Academy, which is Minneapolis' local school. She's like, I hear that you really enjoy mentorship. I want to chat with you about some want very structured, like easy to predict work. And she's like, oh, I really want like fast paced and I just want to be busy. And I'm like, cool, you should look at agency work. And in agency work, you might be looking at open source. You might be looking at a variety of different coding language. And so, versus if she wanted something that was more structured, I was going to say, cool, or corporate, like something like General Mills. And so we got down like she wanted to be fast paced. And so then I was like, well, do you really like aesthetically what the website looks like? Or do you like how it functions? Like what excites you more? And she's like, I really like how it functions. And I was like, awesome. Then you should get into like some backend coding. So maybe PHP or maybe like Ruby or more advanced JavaScript. And so I just asked her a couple of questions and we were able to pinpoint that she wants to get to an agency, possibly learn some more backend coding and do more of the functionality of the website. And that really helped us narrow down jobs. It also helped us narrow down the companies that she wants to work for. And you can do that with just a few quick questions. Be available. This one is super, super hard for me. I'm not super great at this, mainly because I am actually really bad at saying no, so I do everything all the time, and then I'm super busy. But at least be available when you say you're going to be available. So if you, like, they want to have in-person meetings, or maybe online coding sessions, or whatever that looks like for you, set those guidelines and tell them when you're available, and then be available during those times. Share resources with them. So you don't know what you don't know. I've already mentioned that earlier. They may overlook something because they don't know that they need to learn it. Maybe they don't know that React is something that's super important in WordPress or is going to be super important in WordPress. So tell them the things that they should be looking into. Again, the same person I was just chatting about, she was asking me about that. She's like, cool, we learned Angular at the coding, like at Bootcamp. Do you think I should look at something else? And I was like, well, that's completely up to you. But there are, of course, like, there's other JavaScript libraries you can look into. And they don't know some of that stuff unless they talk to someone who knows those things. So tell them those things and share blog posts or online coding tutorials or online, like maybe sessions like this that are recorded. Share that information